He's the T-Rex of political talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
If you've got a question for Bob Chapman, theinternationalforecaster.com, he has predicted almost every trend and development we've seen. Very accurate history, and that's the type of guest we bring you. People who've proven themselves, whereas the mainstream media, the federal government, the Federal Reserve has been lying to you for years, saying everything's wonderful, we're sound, having a debt-based economy is good, go into debt deeper, the whole time they were setting up the public. And we have the IMF and World Bank documents on this. We have the Bilderberg sources on this 3 years ago. They were planning to pop the subprime mortgage in the next year and a half, which they did. And then you can argue that it's gotten out of control for them. I don't know if I agree with that, but regardless, they are going to organize and control their response. And out of the crisis, we see government expanding. We see a consolidation of power, vertical integration, a massive destruction of wealth in that transfer. But again, a greater centralization of wealth. This is no doubt happening. So we'll be taking your calls for Bob Chapman in this hour at 1-800-259-9231. Bob, we've had the chief strategist at the Bank of England come out and say within 2 to 5 years, the dollar will be completely devalued and dumped. That's what you've been saying, 2 to 5 years. You say 2 to 3. Others are coming out and saying similar things. We have one of the biggest fund managers in the world coming out today and saying the entire economy is a Ponzi scheme. I want to get into that. And then we have UBS and the federal government going around shutting down people's Swiss bank accounts, but these are the small fry Swiss bank accounts. This is selectively being done. It's only 18 billion of these 19,000 accounts. Sounds like a lot. It's nothing. We know it's all really going to Dubai and Luxembourg, so that's all part of selective enforcement as well. I'm going to get your analysis on that. But first off, we're suddenly seeing the Economist and all these other publications signal depression. I had Paul Craig Roberts on. He said no way to avert the depression now. He said it will be he agreed with my term, as you have, hyper-stagflation. He said the most devastating combination ever seen. Nothing like this has ever happened. Bob Chapman.
Well, let's start off with Peter, and he put it eloquently. I agree with him. There's only one thing I disagree with, and he believes that by going into other markets and investing in those places that you can avoid some of or these problems in America and perhaps what Western Europe and others are going to experience. And what, in fact, the whole world is going to experience dreadful economic and financial experiences. Nobody is going to be left unscathed. And to think that there'll be a decoupling, I don't think that's going to happen. And that's what Pete is talking about. I think the only true place to be for safety is gold and silver related assets. And if you are a wealthy person and you want to have 20 or 30 or 40% of your assets in another safe place, or a relatively safe place, I have recommended Swiss franc treasuries. Other than that, I don't have anything to offer, other than the fact that's where I disagree with him. But the rest of what he said is absolutely correct.
Well, I mean, when you go into a Mad Max Beyond Thunderdome type crises, you've only want what you can physically hold. All the main analysts are saying this crisis is a black hole that is sucking the world in. And whereas the globalists like to blame the U.S. for this, it's the globalists that did it, and they've run the same Ponzi schemes in every major nation.
And what's happening now, I saw an article this morning from Europe, and they were talking about clients of banks demanding gold coins and gold bars, etc. They haven't seen that in Switzerland since probably the late 1980s. And generally, you know, and throughout Europe.
Explain. Swiss bank accounts are and other safe havens are saying, we don't want your paper. Give us gold or we won't hold it.
Well, they're not going that far, but they're...
I've seen reports of that. Go ahead.
Well, the clients are saying we want gold. I mean, that's just the bottom line. It's as simple as that. I'm sure that there are many pro-gold Swiss bankers today, as 10 years ago there weren't, 20 years ago there weren't. There were in the late 70s because I used to spend a lot of time over there. But, you know, things change. But anyway, as far as the accounts that you mentioned earlier, yes, that is kind of a shovel of sand into the ocean. There's a lot more accounts over there than that. But in October, what happened was that the Swiss banks did agree that any American who was open an account in Switzerland from here on out would have to file a W-9, and they would file it for him. So that means for any new people, there would be no secrecy.
Why are they going after UBS? Why are they closing 19,000 accounts? I mean, we know that the OECD has been saying they don't want any tax havens. They want world taxation in every nation under this new global government run by the central banks, the elite banks, where every nation has on average an 80% tax rate. They say France is the model. They call the United States a tax haven. And now the United States has been empowering worldwide the OECD to go out and try to shut down these accounts, but we know it's selectively being done. Why? I mean, do they just want the money? Are they setting a precedent?
Alex. They want to control everybody's money, and they want to make sure they get every bit of tax that they're supposed to get so they can steal it. And that's really the bottom line on this thing. And this has been underway for the last 8 years under Bush here in the United States. I mean, I've talked to heads of government who have told me right straight to my face over dinner that they came in here, they told us you're going to do this, 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 and this, and if you don't, we're going to cut off your internet, all your communications, all your banking connections. We're going to make it so miserable you'll have no tourism. You either agree or we'll destroy you.
It's just total mafia. And to explain, the ultra-hyper-rich use government as a vacuum cleaner with the umbrella of force to go around the world, including the United States, taxing the middle class and the nouveau riche and the new wealth, sucking it into government. Then it goes offshore to these globalist combines that are outside the law. Example, Goldman Sachs paid less than 1% in corporate taxes in 2008 and in 2007. So they pay basically nothing, and then average citizens, let's say you try to own a car dealership, you try to own a restaurant, you try to own a real estate company, you try to own a clothier, anything, they're going to squeeze the daylights out of you. And then now, let's say you're some middle-class person or nouveau riche person who got money offshore, even money you had earned. A lot of these things are people's money they earn. They just put it overseas. They don't trust U.S. banks. Maybe they want to retire in Europe. They're saying, no, we're taking that money too now. So literally, this is the mafia government.
And that's why it got to be stopped. And if it's not stopped, America is going to be pauperized. And one of the things that Peter brought out and Paul Craig Roberts and I have brought out before is free trade and globalization, which has led to the destruction of the manufacturing industries in the United States. One of the ways that we could stop this that's going on, not financially, but and there's a reason I'm telling you all this, but for the American worker, is simply to invoke, and I think it's coming, invoke trade barriers, things that we've had since the year 1800, tariffs on goods and services. That would reverse this whole thing. Now, I brought this up because all those transnational corporations are making money by manufacturing goods in China, selling them in America, and the profits go to the Cayman Islands. Now, if you remember 3 years ago, what they did was the U.S. Congress, which is bought and paid for, they passed a law which was supposed to insert money into companies in the United States so they could hire more people, increase employment. And that money was to come from these transnationals that had all this money offshore that had never been taxed. And instead of paying 33%, they paid 5.25%. What a sweetheart deal on $360 billion. Now, we should have got 33% of that, we, the American government. And that bears out exactly what you're talking about. Two sets of rules, one for us and one for them.
And they're going for broke. By debasing all the nations of the world, they make us weak, bankrupt, easily controlled. Meanwhile, they are internationalized. They aren't beholden to the same set of rules because they're the internationalists. They're the global government, openly, with the private central bank family, setting world law. I mean, this is the ultimate tyranny. This is like a science fiction nightmare.